Hello, dear friends of the fire. In this video, we introduce you to the atmoco. With it, you can cook and produce biochar out of wood. You will learn how to build and handle it. We, that is the developer Thomas Middelanis, the project Green.Culture, and me, the speaker Julia Binder. The atmoco is a resource-saving stove. You can use it to generate smokeless biochar and cook on it at the same time with up to 3 pots or pans. Biochar improves your soil and makes fertilizer more effective in the long run. At the same time, it is a good way to remove CO2 from the atmosphere. Protecting the atmosphere and soils while we cook, that's the idea behind the atmoco. The stove can be replicated anywhere in the world with simple tools. We are looking forward to your news and experience reports to biochar@posteo.de. Part 1. Gathering the material. You will need the following items. A 200-liter oil barrel with its lid, but only half of it is needed. So from one barrel you can build 2 stoves. A smaller 60-liter oil barrel with its lid. 3 metal tubes, which are about 20 cm long. The inner diameter should be about 2 cm. Of course, the tubes can also be angular as well. An exhaust pipe at least 40 cm long with a diameter of approximately 15 cm. 16 small self-tabbing screws. If you want to use normal screws, you always have to pre-drill with a 2 mm drill bit. Heat-resistant silicone or clay as a material for sealing. Part 2. Using the right tools. Electric power we need only for an angle grinder with cutting a grinding disc for steel, and a cordless screwdriver with a metal drill bit 4 mm thick. Additionally, we need an attachment for the self-tabbing screws, a metal file, a pipe wrench, a hammer, a vise. Last but not least, no clean work without a tape measure or folding rule and a thick felt tip pen. Part 3. Assembling the atmoco step by step. Warning: to avoid injury, please grind off all sawn edges and pierced surfaces. Wear safety goggles and hearing protection when working. The small barrel, the inner chamber. One end of the barrel is slightly narrower than the rest. On this side, we drill about 60 evenly spaced holes with the 4 mm drill. We mark a ring around the barrel exactly 5 cm below the surface and saw through it at the side. Now we lay the barrel on its side and provide the air supply. We drill 3 holes just above the bottom for the metal pipes. The holes have a distance of 40 cm to each other. We thicken the holes with the drill and the file until the inner diameter of the metal pipes is reached. We clamp the metal tubes one after another in the vise and pierce them 4 times about 1 cm before the end. Now we cut in the end of the tube with the angle grinder twice about 2 cm deep. We bend the resulting wings to the side. We then place the tube upright and hit the wing smoothly with the hammer. The wing that has turned out the worst is sawed off. In the next step, we process the holes of the small barrel one after another. First, silicone is smeared around the hole and then the metal tube is placed on top. Through the small holes of the metal tube, we then anchor the screws in the wall of the barrel. We place the small barrel on a flat surface and bend the metal tubes so that they slightly touch the bottom. Now we can smear with the silicone to close small air holes. Then we take the perforated lid and cut it 6 times on the side. A few strokes now make the lid fit. We can simply place it into the small barrel upside down. This allows us to vary the height of the combustion chamber with a little pressure. It's best to try out for yourself how deep the lid should be. That means how much wood you want to use in one pass. To avoid melting silicone, the lid should hang at least 10 cm above the bottom. Since the dimensions of the barrels often differ a little, we measure again exactly the height of the inner chamber, that is, from the ground to the opening. Now calculate the height of the barrel plus 1 cm and remember this number as the cooking height. The big barrel, the outer chamber. We lay the 200-liter barrel on its side and draw 2 rings around it. To do this, we measure exactly from the edge of the bottom or the lid. The distance between the lid or the bottom and the first or second ring must be exactly the same as the cooking height. One of these rings is divided into 6 sections by making a mark every 30 cm. From these marks are drawn connecting lines to the second ring. Now, using the angle grinder, the barrel is divided into cone shape.
only half a barrel we use from now on. The second we can use for another stove. We put the half oil barrel on its 3 feet and put the stovepipe shortly on it, with at least 10 cm distance to the edge. Now, we draw a circle around it. We put the pipe aside again and draw a star of 4 lines in the center of the circle. Along these lines, we now cut gaps in the furnace lid. The cut should end just before the painted circle. We fold up these resulting jacks with the pipe wrench. The exhaust pipe is put on briefly and the furnace is turned upside down. From the inside, we hammer the jacks against the exhaust pipe. Now we turn the barrel back to its feet and process the exhaust pipe. Outside, we draw 2 rings at the distance of 4 and 19 cm from one end. One ring is divided into 6 equal sections. From each mark, we again draw lines at right angles to the second ring. This time, we cut windows in the exhaust pipe. At the other end, we drill through the pipe just under 3 cm from the edge. Here we need 4 evenly spaced holes. Now we put the tube over the jacks on the barrel. To ensure that the pipe stands securely, we turn screws through the 4 holes into the jacks behind it. It is the best to press against the triangle from the inside with a piece of wood. Part 4. Making fire and cooking on the atmoco. Warning! Keep your distance from the stove during the first fire and do not cook on it yet. Here, the paint will come off the metal and there will be fumes that you should not inhale. Filling. We can stack or pile up to 5 cm thick wood in the middle of the inner chamber. The center of the pile should be a few centimeters below the top of the small barrel. On top of this, we spread a layer of fine twigs over the entire area. We also place paper or other fire accelerants in this layer. Ignition. An extensive fire should develop as quickly as possible in the inner chamber. If necessary, add more fine twigs. As soon as fast flames cover most of the firewood, a large barrel can be placed over it. The crucial first minutes. We first place the 3 feet of the large barrel on the metal pipes of the small barrel. This allows more air to flow in from the outside to burn off the rising wood gases. If we see some smoke in the exhaust pipe in the first few minutes, we usually only have to wait a short time for the stove to heat up properly. If the amount of smoke remains unchanged, we can help the heat in the flue pipe by sticking a twig from above through one of the windows. When the air above the flue pipe is clean and we see glowing flames, the cooking can begin. Cooking time. We put a pot or a pan on the exhaust pipe in any case. However, the button will be black later. No later than 5 minutes after placing the outer chamber, we close the 3 tubes with old scraps of cloth. After about 15 minutes, we place the outer chamber directly on the floor. This increases the airflow and makes the cooking plate even hotter. Extinguishing. The biochar is ready when neither flames nor smoke can be seen in the exhaust pipe. Inside the barrel, there are only glowing coals. Now we can extinguish the fire. If the food is not ready yet, we can of course continue cooking without extinguishing, but then ash is formed and we gain less coal. Before we extinguish the coals, we put away all the food. First, we carefully remove the outer chamber and put it to the side. We grab the inner chamber at the bottom by its feet and pour the coals into a fireproof pot, basin, or onto the floor. We extinguish the coals with water. After that, we can grind or crush them. It is the best to put the biochar first in the compost together with garden waste and only later as a mixture into the soil. The team of Green.Culture thank you for your attention and wishes you great experience with the atmoco.